Hi there. I'm Matt with K15T, and let's talk about how you can manage your internal company directories using Confluence databases. Now, this might not seem all that interesting at first, but these are the kinds of things that we do every day, and generally we do them in tables or spreadsheets. But at K15T, we're always making directories of different things, like people or physical items or images or resources, and we use Confluence databases for these things. We also use different database layouts depending on the type of content that is in the directory. Like, for example, here is our learning resource library so that anybody can find our old lunch and learn talks that they want to revisit. There are tags for quickly filtering for the talk people are looking for. There's an abstract that people can use the search bar to skim through. They could look for the host of the event in case it's all they remember, or maybe they remember roughly when the event took place. And of course, there's a direct link to the content, whether it's on a Confluence page or it's recorded in another tool and it's been put in Google Drive, so that no learning opportunity is ever thrown away again. It all lives here in this one searchable Confluence database. But there are many other types of things we might keep track of in a directory. Like, here are some ongoing efforts around the office where we just want to look at all of them in one place and have a rough priority. And then, of course, navigate into the Confluence page where we're actually doing the work for these. General tasks like planning events or improving parts of the office are really easily viewed and managed in this way. Really quick, I would love to know what kind of directories your team is creating, because there are so many fun use cases for directories that we don't even think we're using throughout the day, but I'd love to know what you are going to create a database for, so let me know in the comments below. Okay, let's get back to it. Now let's check out how we can create interconnections between different databases to make our directories really powerful. And we do this using entry field types. So check out this directory of people who work within the organization. So first off, we're using the card layout here to show off each entry in a really visual way because we have the pictures of each employee. But we could change this to another layout at any time and it's all the same information, just displayed differently. This directory is highly used because it has all the details around fellow colleagues and the content is super reusable. So over in the Teams database, for example, we're connecting team members from the colleague database, individuals who coordinate the team, also from the colleague database, the apps the team work on, that's from another database, and then links to that team's work in Confluence. And here's another database where we track the circles that exist within the organization. These are cross-team, cross-functional groups that meet at really regular intervals. So the information about the group, when it meets, what it does, are all here, but then we're using connections back to that colleague database so we can see who is on the team and learn about those people directly. But this is just creating and managing directories in Confluence databases. There is so much more you could do with Confluence. So jump into another video in this series as we continue to explore how to use Confluence to share what you do best.